I don't want this.
Relax, sweetie.
No, stop. I was sexually assaulted by one of the PCs on my team.
So what do you want to do about it?
Nothing, to be honest. I just want him to get on with his job and let me do the same.
Are you honestly telling me it could never have gone further?
What's important is that I said no to you last night and you tried to force me.
Eddie, you just didn't get the message at all, did you?
Hey, come on, Rosie, let me in. It's killing me.
She's an infomania.
I'd reckon she's a bit screwed up.
One minute she's all over and the next she's running a mile.
He grabbed the old bloke, pushed him down, started kicking.
Load of tossed.
Oh, did you hear? She'd been in contact with a Fed rep at Stafford Road.
Go away, Eddie.
I want to know why you lied to me.
I want to know why you needed to talk to the Fed rep at Stafford Road. Rosie! Rosie!
Hi, this is Rosie. I'm not in right now, but if you'd like to leave a message, please do so after the beep.
Hello, darling. It's Mum. It's 1:30. You're probably at work. We were just wondering how you are. How's the new job going? Are the people nice? Dad's keen to know how you're getting on. You know what he's like. OK, if you get a minute later, give us a call, could you? Bye, love. Talk soon.
Come on!
Sausage!
Behave!
Is he comfortable?
Well, I hope not. He bit me.
Hey, look at that.
Gnat's bite.
Oh, I noticed you stayed well clear, Sarge.
Well, I could see you had it under control. Anyway, in 10 minutes' time is the late turn's problem.
Then you can get out of your system on the battlefield.
Yeah. I'm ready to kick some butt today. Keep your eyes peeled, Sarge. You're on my hit list now.
Dream on, Rambo.
Give you that.
It's a great day for your girlfriend to be short-handed.
Hey, she's not my girlfriend, remember? I pulled out of that nosedive.
She's probably pining. Of course, you dumped her.
Either that or she's having another cosy with the Stafford Road Fed rep. And what do you reckon that's all about, then? It's put George's nose right out of joint.
Oh, beats me. You'd have to ask her, but then could you believe what she told you? I don't think I could anymore.
Do you want to make a donation to the paintball challenge, Gov?
I suppose so. Have they decided which charity it is, it?
Well, it depends. If the governors win, it's the National Holiday Fund for Disabled Children. If the ranks win, it's a drug rehabilitation project.
All right. Stick me down for a tenner. Do something for the children, eh?
Gov.
Oh, hi, Jamila.
Oh, hi. I thought you were ill.
I was. I'm feeling better. Hey, do you know the way out to the paintball site?
Yeah, we're going on the minibus. Leaves the yard at 10 past.
Right, I'll grab a drink. See you out there.
Oi!
Sarge.
Where are you going?
A coffee machine, Sarge.
And then where?
Paintballing, Sarge.
Can you come in here a minute? I thought you were sick.
I was sick, Sarge. I had a migraine, but it's cleared up.
Isn't it funny why these symptoms always show up on early turn and then disappear when you're going to have some fun?
I wasn't well, Sarge. It's the truth. But I want to make this event. It's important.
And why is that?
Well, since I've got here, I've been attached to CID and I just don't feel part of the relief somehow. I thought this might be a chance to build some bridges.
Really? Well, if you want to build some bridges with me, make sure you're here for parade at 6 sharp tomorrow morning. Migraine or no migraine.
Sarge. Thank you, Sarge.
Oh, are you coming with us then?
Yeah.
Great.
Oh, well, look who it is. Part-timer.
Don't come to my house again.
Why? What are you going to do? Ooh, tell the Fed rep about me. Oh, no, you've already done that, haven't you?
Look, Ed, I know what you're thinking.
Oh, to be honest, I don't give a stuff anymore. You've crossed the line with me, Rosebud. You've blown it big time.
Rosie. Who's taking the sponsorship pledges?
Eddie or Dave, I think. They arranged it.
Well, there's 80 quid and promises from CID.
Thanks, I'll pass it on.
Well, you look faint and fit. What's the problem?
Oh, half the relief think I'm a stuck-up duplicitous cow, but apart from that, it's just great.
Do they? Why?
I don't know. It's a long story, and Eddie Santini's got his version.
Where are they going for a drink after?
The grapes.
Right, I'll tell you what, I'll meet you there. We'll find a nice quiet corner and you can tell me all about it.
Oh, I'm not sure that's such a good idea. I want to get on with these people, not isolate myself even further.
Hey, I am one of these people. I'll see you later, all right?
OK, thanks. See you.
Now then, troops. Ready to do battle?
Ready as we'll ever be, sir.
We're really looking forward for this. How we look?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm really scared.
Crazy. We get slaughtered.
No way, not by this lot.
You as well, Derek.
Why, what's the problem?
You're a bit long in the tooth to be playing soldiers.
Well, I'm looking forward to it as it happens.
Very commendable. Lead from the front, mate.
Right, John.
Go.
CID's pledges.
Oh, nice one.
Everybody here then, Bob?
Think so, sir.
Ah, Dave, could you sort out some volunteers to make our numbers up?
No, sir, I didn't know.
Well, why not? I specifically asked you to organise it. We're outnumbered 4-1.
Well, I asked around, but nobody wanted to be on the losing side, sir.
Great.
All right, I want half a dozen volunteers to make up our team. Anyone? Rosie?
Yes, Sarge.
You with us?
Sarge.
Good. Anyone else? No? Right, you, and you. Thank you.
Can we get going now, Bob?
Yeah. Right, sir.
Right, let's be off.
We're on the A team then, George.
Yeah, yeah, if you sign, Rosie.
Yeah, watch your back, George.
Oh, just bringing up the rear.
Wait for the minibus. Best to be travelling convoy.
Well, I hope you don't mind me mentioning this, Andrew, but I thought it best if I assume command of the battle, don't you?
Well, I suppose so. I hadn't thought about it, sir.
Well, I am Chief Inspector Ops. It does make sense. What do the others think?
Well, nobody's mentioned it to me. I shouldn't think they'd object.
No.
Do we need a leader?
Well, of course we need a leader. We've got to have a strategy. It'd be chaos otherwise. Well, you can do it if you want.
No, I really don't care, sir. It's only a game.
And what kind of attitude is that? We're supposed to be setting an example. It may only be a game, Andrew, but we've got to play to win.
Yes, sir. I suppose you're right.
I am right. No point playing otherwise.
Right, that's it then. Governors 3-1, ranks even money favourites.
Hang on, how'd you work that out?
Average age, big handicap.
Yeah, but the ranks are carrying most of the women. You know what girlies are like. Once the muck and bullets start flying and the mascara starts running, my money's on the governors, fiver.
Right. Tom, you in?
No, I'm busy, Sarge. I'll catch you later.
OK. Jim, who'd you fancy?
Oh, I'm not all that bothered, thanks.
Come on, Jim, don't be so miserable.
I've already pledged to the charity. I'm not made of money.
Oh, what a tightwad.
Governors are ranks.
Oh, we're all ranks up this end. Thanks.
Not getting changed, son.
No, I don't care if these get dirty. I've got some clean ones in my bag.
You'll regret it.
I wouldn't put too much padding on. You'd be drenched in sweat.
I'll take that risk, thanks. Governors are ranks.
Governors.
Pick up your guns, masks and ammo on your way to the combat zone.
I won't have to do that.
What's that?
This, Andrew, is the Ultramag RT, rapid trigger. It's got a 1,000-shot canister, capable of discharging 24 rounds per second. You could fire all day with this baby, drop a rhinoceros.
Where'd you get it?
From my nephew.
How old's he?
12.
Right, gents, take your card.
What for?
Highest card is Commander-in-Chief.
Well, I assumed I'd be in command.
Well, the troops wanted something a bit more democratic since it's out of working hours, sir.
Well, that's absurd.
Well, it's what they want.
What do you think, Andrew?
I've no objection, sir.
All right, what do I have to do?
Beat the Jack. The Jack's gone. You're the last two to pick.
8-4.
Bad luck, sir.
Who picked the Jack, then?
Reg did.
Well. Right. The rules of engagement. Team A, the governors, will defend their flag from base A. Team B will mount their attack from base B, capture the flag and return it to their base. Whistles will signal the beginning and the end of the exercise. There will be no headshots, no hand-to-hand combat.
God, he fancies himself, doesn't he?
You will keep your goggles on at all times. When you are hit, you will raise your right arm and retire to the dead zone immediately and take no further part in the battle. In any dispute, my decision is final.
Right, marshals, attention teams.
OK, over to the practice zone.
Come. Right, here we go, lads. Come on, you yellows.
Our team leader.
Go on, yellows.
Bullseye.
Sorry, sorry,
whoa.
Hey!
Eddie.
Oi, you! No firing till the battle starts.
You all right, love?
I'm fine.
All right, let's go.
Next. Right, come on, yellows! You're
going to miss each time, eh?
Come on, you lot!
Come on, sir.
Take your time, Andrew. Plenty of cover here, isn't there?
Yes, sir.
Shouldn't be too difficult to defend, I think.
Come on, let's get going. All right, OK, listen up, everybody. Wait, listen up. Right, pincer movement, yeah?
Yeah?
That's Jamila, Sam, Polly, Debbie, down the flanks.
Right.
Myself, Tony and Luke will form an advance party through the middle, soften them up a bit.
Right,
and then a second wave, that'll be Eddie, Vicky and the rest will go in, mop up.
Oh, no, 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 let me go in the advance party. I really want to be in the thick of it.
I'll go on.
Well, you go with Tony, swap with me.
Oh, no.
Right, now then.
5 minutes.
Right, everybody ready?
Yeah.
100%. We want to win this!
Yes!
Come on!
Yes!
Come on!
Rach! There you go.
Wallace, what's happening? Where's everybody going?
I've sent an advance party to operate behind enemy lines.
You've done what?
Yeah, you know, a covert force, like the SAS.
Ah, oh, that's ridiculous.
Why is that, sir?
Well, it's cheating, for one thing. The whistle hasn't gone yet.
Well, it's fair in love and war, sir.
And another thing. As everybody knows, an invading force needs vastly superior numbers to succeed. All we have to do is dig in here and wait. You've weakened our position.
I disagree, sir. I've always thought that the best form of defence was attack. Now, look, Gary and I were going to stay here and guard this flag. Rosie, I want you to go well forward with George, all right? Stay undercover. Go on, now. Now, sir, I would like you and Mr. Monroe to go over there and take up sniper positions behind those drums, OK?
Now, listen, Hollis. We'll be totally exposed out there. If somebody comes behind us, we'll be wiped out.
Sir, I'm in command here now. I'd like you to go and take those positions, please.
Hollis, you're an idiot. Do you know
that? I don't think
you
heard me.
We haven't got much time, sir.
Sir, it's about to start.
I'll cover you when you come in, right?
OK.
This is what comes in mixing officers with ranks. He wants us to take a whack in, doesn't he?
I doubt it, sir. Anyway, we'll have to make the best of it, won't we? I'm taking up position. Good luck.
Come on, then. Let's have you.
Get across and cover us. Go on. Go on.
Unit base and Cryer.
Hey, guys, huh?
Three coming down the centre.
Two groups of two on either flank. The rest are coming as backup.
Understood, Sergeant. Keep me informed.
Will do.
Reg,
I'm impressed.
Yeah, well, look, Dave and Ellie think it's going to be a bit of a walkover. But I'm telling you, no one's going to get that flag without a fight, all right? Oh, and, Gary, if there's any confusion in the heat of the battle, take your orders from me, all right?
Yes, Reg. You're the boss.
Should have put some overalls on, Luke. These paintballs can really hurt at close range.
Gary, you should have told me that before.
Didn't want to worry you.
Shh!
Stay here.
You all right?
No, I'm dead.
Who the hell was that?
Don't know, but get him for me.
Don't. Who's that?
It's Vicky.
Go!
Go, yes! Red!
Ow! Ow, no! Rosie, you see him getting out behind them?
That's Rosie.
Man coming through.
See, the firearms training came in handy then, Tony. I'm dead! I'm dead!
Yeah, you are now.
Go!
Reg, Santini's group are heading for the barrier. Make sure someone's come round to the flanks to cover. And Dave's made a break to join them, but it's all right, because June and George are coming round to cover it. Make sure Gary's standing by, just in case he's needed.
Sarge.
Terrific.
Do you want to surrender?
I suppose so.
Tough.
Sorry about that, Sarge. Get back to the dead zone, get yourself a cup of coffee.
After you. Team's taking the right hammering, isn't it, Tony?
Not looking good, is it?
Hmm. All right, Sarge.
Yeah.
Who's got you two?
Someone called the Terminator.
Yeah, me as well. Who is it?
Search me.
What's happening, Andrew?
I'm not sure.
I haven't fired a shot yet. No, I'm not having this.
In this position.
Yes, sir.
Hand combat. Come on. Just calm it down. You're dead. You're both dead. Now back to the compound, please. No wonder she's pissed off. She's been killed by one of her own team.
Yeah, isn't fair. I want you to do it.
Who is that over there?
Vicky Hagen, I think.
She won't bother us from over there. I got one, you know.
Oh, good.
Don't know who it was.
Sir, cover your own position. I know. Cover the other flank.
Idiot.
Been for a walk in the woods, have we?
She was killed by friendly fire.
Gary, stay forward.
What's that, sir?
Stay forward.
But Reg wants me back.
I can't bloody stay forward.
Tom?
Yeah, it looks like the ranks are dropping like flies, mate. Yeah, I'll bet on them if I was you, yeah.
OK, Tom, thanks. Don?
Yes, Jim?
What odds did you say you were offering on the governors?
3-1, why?
Put me down for a tenner.
Oi, come on, Dave, I got you.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did. You know I did. You're dead, all right?
Rubbish!
Paint check!
Yeah, it's just on his shoulder, Governor.
Right, let's have a look. You're a dead soldier.
Yeah, go on, Dave, get out of it.
We'll get nearer these snipers in position. We'll have to take them out then, won't we? Right. Ready?
Dave's given me a cola.
You see, you are, I wouldn't have done. You left him for dead out there.
Yeah, well, I went on a fox hunt, didn't I? Big mistake. Yeah, well, maybe I should take this over, eh? Try and make up for it.
Up to you.
All right, Chuckles, mind if I join you?
Yes, go.
Ooh. Boy, do you know how to have a good time. Here, drink this. Might warm me up a bit.
Oh,
whoa, sorry.
Get away from me!
Oh, Sad, I was sorry. Come here, come on.
What the hell are you doing? You can't treat me like this. Leave me alone. Oh,
for God's sake, Rosie, I never wanted to hurt you. It just didn't work out.
What?
I'm sorry it's over. Can't you just accept that?
You bastard! You crazy, evil bastard! Oh, you bastard!
Just calm down, come on!
What are you all staring at? Rosie!
What was all that about? She's taking it worse than I thought. Luke?
Is it over then, sir?
Yeah, it is.
Oh, thank God for that.
Game over!
Liz.
G&T. Debbie, do you know where Rose is?
No idea.
No,
she blew a stack at the paintball site and stormed off.
Something to do with Eddie. Really?
Hey, Commissars, you never said you played before. How's that to know?
Yeah, but there's a lot you don't know about me. I have my light under a bushel.
How much we get, Dave?
280 quid.
There's another 30 from CID.
Oh, nice one, Jim.
Cheers. Don't mess with a Terminator.
Yeah, all right, terminate that size, we'll get you another. Yeah.
Deb, did you see where she was going?
Not to me.
Right.
line, hang on. Luke Ashton, for courage and valour beyond a call of duty, we award you your posthumous VC.
Back on my turf tomorrow, Reg.
Oh, yes, sir. Reg is a jolly good fellow. All of you. Reg's a jolly good fellow. Reg's a jolly good fellow.
Not really cheerful for a man who was on the losing side.
Well, we lost the battle, but we'll win the war.
And what about Rosie?
Yeah, well, unrequited love's a bore, as the song says. You have to put things behind you and move on. And to tell you the truth, Liz, there's a few things I've learned about Rosie that I'm not too impressed with.
Yeah, like what?
Well, she's flaky for one thing, and for another, she's not a team player, and I don't like that.
Time for another, Red?
Yeah, soon can be.
Yeah?
No, thanks.
Yeah. Might as well drown our sorrows.
Minding our unexploded bombshell for the day, didn't
you? Yeah, I'm in court with her all day.
Better keep your protective clothing on, mate.
Give him a break, will you?
He's had a break. Gary's had a deal since the paintball and the performance.
Yeah, I think I heard her ticking.
She needs a good talking to.
She's no good to us, sobbing into her handkerchief like an overheated schoolgirl every time Eddie walks by.
There's nothing in her record to suggest that she's had personal problems at work before.
She needs putting straight, June. She's not helping the team to keep their eye on the ball either.
So, are you going to then? Talk to her? Right, I get it.
Be better coming from you.
Do you know, I don't believe you two, as if I haven't got enough on my plate as it is. Right then, I'll have a word with her at the end of the shift.
Mr. Douglas to court number four.
All right, sir, thank you.
Mr. Douglas to court number four.
Looks like we need divine intervention on this one.
Well, it's worth a try. What should I do, sacrifice a cat?
Matt.
Yes, Bob. What can I do for you today?
We've got a live one due in for Corps 5. I was wondering if we could have a few extra hands when he's brought up.
Michael Sarby. What's his problem?
Just like any other mad dog. Likes to hurt people.
I've never been waiting on drinks since 7! These cats are climbing!
Not a freak sight. The SO has put a note on. He's been smashing up, making threats to the witness.
You too, Sergeant.
Nice, slack bone! Stu Jeffries, you suck up!
Yeah, I'll see you in court then, Michael.
I had a go yesterday, but she just blanked me. I said, look, we all understand how cut up you are about Eddie and everything.
What's she saying?
Oh, I can't talk about it right now.
Haven't you got to collect someone for court, Rosie?
Yes, Sarge. Thanks.
Oh, come in. Oh, Rosie, I was going to talk to you later. What's up?
I wanted to ask whether it would be possible for me not to be partnered with Eddie for a while.
Well, you're not, are you? I mean, except for today, you're with Gary.
I know, but Gary's on holiday next week, and Eddie and I have had some problems personally.
Yes, I had noticed.
It would make it a whole lot easier for me.
Hang on, Rosie. I could hardly have missed what's going on between you and Eddie, but the Rotas aren't organised for officers' personal convenience, are they? If you've got problems with him, then you have to sort that out in your own time.
Sarge, in normal circumstances, I wouldn't ask, but I think I don't want what's happening to affect my work, and I'd really appreciate the chance to put a bit of space between us just for a month or two.
No, I'm sorry, Rosie. Whatever's going on between you and Eddie is already impinging on your work and other people's. Now, you were warned the other day when Jason Jeffries went AWOL. I'm really disappointed that I'm having to repeat what I said then.
Sarge, I'm doing my best. Eddie's not... is not making it any easier.
Look, Rosie, if you're really having problems managing Eddie at work, then you need to talk to somebody about it. I've already offered to listen.
I know, Sarge.
But if you're not interested in doing that, then you have to cope with it in your own way and in your own time.
Sarge.
Okay, off you go. And, Rosie, If you change your mind about talking, I'm always here.
Thanks, Sarge.
You ready?
What was all that about with Sergeant Ackland?
Huh? Are you in there telling tales about me?
Leave me alone.
Anything interesting in the post this morning?
Yeah, I'm keeping some too. They're cute, aren't they? Yeah, I might put them up on the wall of the section house, yeah? A little memento, what might have been.
Just watch it, Eddie.
You watch it, Rosebud, right? I want you to understand this clearly. You try anything moody, any little revenge tactics, and you're going to regret it sooner rather than later.
Sarvi is real trouble, Alex. He's in the mood, he could kick off in court. I want you to ask the judge to have him brought up in handcuffs.
50-1 will be turned down, John. Is it really...
Look, Alex, do you want to take my word for it, or do you want to hold hands with Sarvi for 5 minutes? See if that changes your mind.
Security to reception, please. Security to reception, please.
All right, Jason, you feeling fit?
I'm okay.
You had a Valium before you left. Should help.
Just a thing you could do with Rosebud. Few lessons off Julie and what being a woman's all about.
So it's a no, then?
Judge Barnwell is of the firm opinion that it is unnecessary and could unfairly prejudice the jury against the defendant.
Sarvi could have a go at any time, Alex. He's done worse.
Sorry.
They're bringing Sarvi up now.
Tell Jason good luck for me. I'll see you at the circus.
Yeah. What's he here for?
OK. Right, march him on.
Yeah! Would the defence counsel for Adams please go to court number two?
They're not as tough as they look. Are they? Sorry?
Oh, forget it, love. She doesn't speak your language.
Hi, how's Jason?
Quiet.
And what about you? You stopped answering your phone or something?
Well, I have been out quite a lot.
Look, they're just about to start. Jason's first up after the opening speech, OK?
OK, I'll let him know.
Members of the jury, this is really a very straightforward case. The defence will not disagree with the circumstances of Mr. Mackey's assault, nor with the fact that he was robbed. But they will try to suggest that the man who attacked and robbed Mr. Mackey was not Michael Sowerby. That's their job. Fortunately for justice and for Mr. Mackey, someone else was in the park that evening who witnessed the attack clearly, who saw Michael Sowerby venting his rage on Mr. Mackey when he resisted...
That's crap! They're paying the witness!
Mr. Sowerby, shut up and stay seated or I'll send you down to the cells.
Shall I get on and call the said witness?
Good idea.
Call Jason Jeffries.
Remember what Liz told you, Jay. Stick to your guns. He'll be over in no time.
What if they decide he's not guilty?
Just tell them exactly what you saw, yeah?
Yeah.
How's Jason holding up?
So far, so good. But I want to know what's going on with you, Rosie.
Look, Liz. It's all this stuff with Eddie.
What stuff with Eddie? I really don't understand what's going on.
Oh, don't you? Everyone else seems to.
What's that supposed to mean? Look, Rosie, what's going on?
I really can't talk about this here, Liz.
Just give me a brief outline, then.
You won't believe me.
Try me.
I turned Eddie down that night after the op. He followed me to the locker room after I left the party. He assaulted me, Liz. First he tried pretending it never happened, now he's trying to wobble me enough to make me...
Make you what?
I don't know. Transfer, go crazy, slip my wrist. I don't think he minds which. Not what you thought, is it?
No. No, it isn't. Look, Rosie, I'm really... Why didn't you tell me this before?
Oh, loads of reasons. I thought I could handle it. And I didn't want to rock the boat after I'd only just got on board. And... Actually, can we do this later?
You said that the last time.
No, really. I'd appreciate it.
Yeah, OK, whatever you want.
saw this man come up behind. He grabbed the old bloke, and there was a struggle. The old bloke put up quite a fight, but the man just punched and kicked him till he was just lying still on the ground.
Do you see the man who attacked Mr. Mackey in court today, Mr. Jeffries?
It's him in the dock.
The defendant?
Yeah.
Are you absolutely sure?
Yes.
You're lying on a dead man.
Mr. Sabi, you will remain silent unless addressed.
Okay. One more question, Mr. Jeffries. Can you tell me why, if you witnessed Mr. Sowerby attack Mr. Mackey so clearly, you didn't try to stop it?
I couldn't. I didn't dare let him see I was there.
So what did you do?
I ran away.
Thank you, Mr. Jeffries. No more questions.
So, Mr. Jeffries, you've told the court you have a fairly clear picture of the time and the circumstances in which you saw Mr. Mackey attacked.
Yes.
How far were you from Mr. Mackey when you were hiding in the bushes?
About 12 feet, 15 maybe.
So somewhat less than the distance between you and the defendant now?
Yes.
Can you see Mr. Sowerby clearly?
Yes.
Can you see his face clearly?
Yes.
Describe it to me.
He's got a darkish complexion, short hair and blue eyes.
Well observed. Very true. Now, when you gave your description of the attacker to officers at Sun Hill, you described him as dark-haired and tall and wearing a dark jacket. Is that correct?
I think so, yes.
But you made no mention at all of his complexion, the length of his hair, or the colour of his eyes.
I wasn't noticing details.
But you've already stated you were really quite a lot nearer to the attacker on that evening than you are to Mr. Sowerby now.
Yes.
So why didn't you notice the details, being that much closer?
I just didn't see them.
But you see them now, quite clearly.
It was getting dark, and there were the bushes.
So, Mr. Jeffries, your testimony is that even though you were only 12 feet from the attacker, you didn't notice the details of his face because it was getting dark and the bushes were in the way.
I know it was him.
How can you be sure?
I know what I saw.
Mr. Jeffries, wouldn't it be fairer to say that it might have been him? Or equally, that it might have been someone else?
No, I... What should I say?
No further questions, Your Honour.
Wait a minute.
Mr. Jeffries.
This isn't right. He didn't listen to what I said.
Because it's rubbish.
Instruct your client he won't be given another warning. I imagine you would like a short adjournment, Ms. Creech.
Yes, Your Honour.
But...
Mr. Jeffries, you may leave the witness stand. Court will adjourn for half an hour.
All rise.
I've done it again.
Oh, don't panic. Come on.
OK, Jason, you've got to pull yourself together.
Look, you just had a bit of a wobble. It happens. We'll go back in and Alex will re-examine.
Go back in?
We do understand how you're feeling, Jason. It's very intimidating in there, and the defence counsel is trying his hardest to put you off. But you've got through it. Alex will ask a few more questions, and then it'll all be over. You can do that, can't you?
I don't know.
You know what you saw.
Maybe I was wrong.
Sowerby's just nutted a security officer and escaped through the window.
Kasura, sit down. Okay, get in, get settled down. The officers from 5 area will call you before they come to replace you, okay? Fine. Good luck.
If I'd done different, we wouldn't be here now.
No, you'd probably still be in hospital, like Mr. Mackey.
It's part of the consequences I have to accept.
Oh, very philosophical, mate.
Right, Julie, there's everything you need in there to make tea. Eddie and I are going to check around, make sure we're all secure.
Okay, thanks.
Will you just back off from Jason for a bit? The poor bloke's in a total state.
Oh, shut up, Rosebud. Stay right out of my face. Speak only when spoken to. Get it?
Right, this is the bloke we're after.
It was a bit weird, though, the way she flipped out.
Thanks. Favourite is like fatal attraction.
Eddie should have seen her coming.
Love's blind, isn't it?
It's a shame, though. I mean, she never seemed that type at first.
Well, women like that have often got emotional struggles.
Women like what?
All right, let's get on with it. We've got an escaped prisoner to find.
Oh, well, you're still in with a chance, Reg. Catch you on the rebound.
I think Reg has got better taste than that, haven't you, honey bunch?
Yeah.
Welcome to this afternoon's racing from Newcastle. The weather is dry and bright, and the going is firm. And as we join the cameras in the paddock...
You all right, love?
Yeah.
This is so weird. I'll have to call work, let them know. Be careful what you say about where you are, just in case.
Who's that?
Don't stress, mate. We'll see who it is. It'll be the babysitters.
They said they'd call first.
Nothing there. Come on.
Stay here.
Yeah, who is it? Best not to advertise.
Sorry?
Better safe than clearing up the mess afterwards. I'm Neil, this is Jackie.
You were supposed to call.
Yeah, sorry, my mobile's on the blink. You're nice, what's your name?
Okay then, see you later.
DC was friendly. You missed an opportunity. You could have pulled there, Rosebud.
All right? Yep. Any sign of Sabi?
No, not yet.
Better get back out there and find him then, eh, Rosebud?
I'm hungry. I fancy an ice cream.
You've only just had your tea.
An hour ago.
It'll go to your hips, Polly.
You sound like my mum. What did I say?
Over there, by the bookies.
Oscar from Sierra One, receive him.
Go ahead, Paul.
We've just spotted Michael Sauer, this Sarge. DS Bolton's escaped prisoner. He's on foot, heading north on Caney Road. We're in pursuit.
All units, attention requested to Caney Road. Area car in pursuit of escaped prisoner Michael Sowerby. Sierra One from Sierra Oscar. Location, please, Paul.
Yeah, we're in Brunel Lane. No sign of him,
there
though.
He goes.
Right, all units from Sierra One. Prisoner held in sight of us. He's making towards the old nursing home behind Burkett Warehouse. Oscar from 469. He's gone inside.
Right, I'll get on to MP, see if they've got any dog units available.
He went in on the first floor.
Is he still up there?
Yeah. Should we get on with it?
Are you sure it was Sabi?
No, we made it up.
We'll need dogs.
Off you go, then.
They're on their way.
Him, Sarge. He's definitely in there.
Okay, Paul, right. You go with the dog. You two, you go with Dave and Luke. Start making your way up the building and then we'll watch the exits. Right, everybody, listen, I want you to stay in your pairs at all times and stay in radio contact. You report anything that you see or hear. If Salby is in there, then he's not going to put his hands up without a fight. All right, off you go.
Here, Eddie. Should have bought the paint guns, could have had a go. Right, you go that way, we'll meet you up the top, yeah?
Dave. Can I ask you something?
Go on.
Eddie and Rosie.
Pass.
What?
Informed.
Not gonna jump, are you?
Shut up.
Positive ID.
I'm not sure it's the same bloke.
He's out of the building, into the yard. Can you confirm it's Salby, Vicky?
Where are you off to?
Going in for the kill.
We don't even know if it's Salby.
Well, stay here if you want.
We're not supposed to separate, you stupid jerk.
Oh, leave it out, Rose, but I've had enough tickings off from you to last a millennium. Go find someone else to abuse. Come on!
What are you doing here? Why'd you run away?
I just wanted somewhere to DOS.
All units, we've got the runner, but it is not Sowerby.
Repeat, the suspect is not Sowerby.
Told you.
Easy does it. They've taken us by surprise here. Let's just calm down, sort ourselves out.
48 from 340. We've got Salby, Sarge, but we've also got a problem. Switch to channel 2.
Yeah, what's going on, Dave?
He's got Rosie up on the roof and he wants transport out.
Okay, I'm on my way.
What are you doing?
I'm just calling my governor in. They've got to authorise the car.
Well, yeah, that's the problem, mate. The wheels turn slowly, but we can deal with it. We just need to work out...
I want a vehicle! It doesn't need any working out!
Yeah, sure, we hear you. And in a situation like this, what we try and do is cooperate as much as possible and to reassure you that we're going to do everything...
Wait! How long?
Well, it's hard to say, mate. But in the meantime, what we can do is...
I told you, just shut it!
Yeah, I know, I'm sorry. I'm nervous, it makes me talk. But what I'm trying to do is...
I know what you're trying to do.
I just...
Look! I can take a face off with this.
Just want to help you sort it out.
No!
Come on,
okay, don't move. Stay there.
Right, get him downstairs, you two. Rosie? You're right, what happened?
I don't really know, do you, Rosie?
You don't know?
Oh, I was standing over there listening to Vicky on the radio and Rosie was like, she's like feet away.
You lying bastard, you walked away, you let it happen.
What are you talking about, Rosie?
I'm not letting you do this to me, do you hear me, Eddie?
All right, Rosie, now you stop that, okay?
You listening, Eddie? You're not going to walk away from this, you bastard. I'm not lying down for this anymore.
She's gone to CID, alleging sexual assault.
What? Aren't you making this into a personal war?
I didn't start it, Liz. I didn't want any of this. He's obsessed.
I've got an idea for a different kind of solution to this thing, if you'll listen to me a minute.
What idea? Why are you bothered, Dave?
I want to help.
Where'd you get off, Dave? And when'd you stop acting like the moral majority and just get on with your life?
When I decide that you could be trusted, which could be a very long time.
Well, I don't need you as my big brother, right?